Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video we are going to talk about animation with Adobe Illustrator. Now, of course, there are applications that can do this a lot better than Illustrator can because they have all the bells and whistles to do animation. But you can do some things in Illustrator as well. So let's dive right in. And I have prepared a file here and I want to animate this drawing of a zebra. So this is a live paint group and we need to take this apart. It would be possible to do something using the puppet tool, but with this kind of drawing, it might get difficult. And there's a different tool to do this, and we're going to take a look at it. But in order to use it, we need to prepare this drawing. So what we need to do is prepare this in a way that it can be separated, so that we can separate the body, the tail, the legs, and the head and the neck. And to do this, we need to add some lines into this live paint group and we need to straighten the legs in order to prepare them. So let's enter it, go into isolation mode by double clicking this. Now I'm in isolation mode and what we need to do is add some lines. So we need to make this better separable by making this line longer and then add a line here so these can be separated as well. And then we need to straighten those legs. So what we can do is take the lasso tool and select all these anchor points and then set the center of rotation with the rotate tool and adjust this, move the points and all of this. I'm going to exit it here because I have prepared that already. So let's exit it and then let's show this zebra. So this is what I have prepared and this is still a live paint group. So what we can do is just expand that and then let's ungroup it and then let's ungroup it again. So there are all the parts and what we now need to do is separate them, group this, and we need to do some edits here so we can have an easier animation like so. And then let's group this and the next thing is we take these and group them and group those as well. And then we can make the body slightly larger so that it can hide if there are some irregularities later, like so. And then let's take the tail, all of them, group them, do the same with the body. And there's still one part and now group that all. And again, we can perhaps make this slightly larger, like so. And now we're going to select the head and group that as well, like so. So next thing is we want to move that in the different rotation. So let's reflect it with the reflection tool, like so. And now, in order to be able to animate this, we need some preparation and we need to rotate them so that they are lying flat, like so, and these as well. The direction is important, So we are drawing them from left to right, and left are the hooves, like so. And now the tool we are going to use is the brush tool. Respectively, we are only going to use brushes. You don't need the tool to use them, but the brushes are kind of useful. So let's create art brushes for this, and they can be used to deform objects easily. So this one is front, and the next one is also front, and then we have the back and another back leg, and then we have the tail, like so. And we can soon see just how easy it is to form objects using brushes. So I'm going to create this based on Edward Muybridge's photos of a galloping horse. And I have already placed the template, and there we have frame one, and I have created some layers for my animation, and let's just turn on layer one. This one is locked, that's fine. And now what we can do is draw the elements. And I'm going to start with the actual brush tool to draw the body. So let's just draw a line like so, and then we can still edit it and maybe delete that anchor point so it's easier to make the shape that we need. And then of course we need to decide which legs are behind and which are in front. So what we can do while we are on layer one, we decide that this one is in the back and it's the one that's currently in front. So in order to draw the next body element, I'm just going to use the pen tool. And let's do it like this. And let's apply this one. And this leg actually needs to be in the back. And then we have the body. And the next one is this leg. So let's do that just with three clicks and apply the next one. And then we can take a look and see if this matches, like so. And here we need to decide which leg is behind. And let's just draw it. And it's this one. And the leg needs to be behind this as well. And let's maybe put the body in front. And then we draw the next leg, like so, and assign this one. And then we still need the tail. So let's draw a line again, and I'm going to just repeat that and apply this brush. And now what we can do is arrange all of them and see that all of this matches. Put the body in front and then add the tail here, like so. You see, it's really easy to make all these transformations using the brush, and then let's add the head, like so. And this needs to be just on this layer. And the next thing you can do is now duplicate all these elements. So what we're going to do is just take this group and all the other ones, and then let's press the Alt key and duplicate it to the next layer. And what you can then do is hide layer number one, show number two, and then do the same with the templates, like so. So let's just unlock that and do it like so. And then what we can do is take all these elements, and this leg needs to be rotated slightly. Do the same with this one, and then we can also check. So we need to add something and just move it like so. And this is just how you do all the editing to adjust the state of the zebra's limbs, and they need to be edited slightly more. So let's do this like so, and the other leg needs to be moved like so, and that's the way you adjust them. And then of course as well you can adjust the state of the head and move it slightly downwards, and also of course you can slightly stretch it, and then of course you need to adjust the body. And that's how you can make all the states of the animation. And thankfully I've got a file where I've done that already, which is this one. So you see, this one contains all the states of the animation, and we can of course check this out and check all the different states to try them out. The next thing is we need to prepare this to be animated, and for creating the animated GIF I'm going to use an extension, which is the extension GIF Studio. This one I'm going to put a link in the comments of this video. And this extension uses artboards for creating an animation. So first what we have to do is separate all these layers on artboards, because to create all the movement it's better to have layers, because they can lie on top and you can compare them better. But for creating the actual animation we need to separate these. So in order to do that I'm going to use a script, and for the script I have prepared that in a way that they are all groups, and inside of the group we have the brushes, but all the states need to be a separate group. So let's select all of them and then let's call the script. I'm going to file scripts and other script, and then let's use that. I'm going to put a link to that in the comments as well. So let's just apply it, and you see we get all the states of the animation on their own artboards. And now it's pretty easy. I'm going to open the extension and then let's just load the artboards into the extension. So we need to click this button, and there we have all the artboards in here. And what we can now do is select all of them, like so, so they are all selected. And then let's set this to a low number. And now we can also test it. And you see there is the animation and it looks like it goes backwards. So that wasn't the plan. So what we now need to do is arrange them in a different way. So let's go to the artboards panel and let's see if we can move them around. So I'm pretty sure that there is a script for that as well, but I don't have that prepared. So let's just move them in a different order by moving them around in the artboard panel. And I'm just rearranging their order, like so. And that was pretty fast. So let's go to GIF Studio again and let's stop this here, go in here and let's load all of them again. And let's see if this worked by testing that. This is quite slow, so we need to select them again and set this. Let's see if we can enter our own number, like so. It's even faster now. And you see, this is how it should be. So that's nice. And now we can just export it. So let's put this into our folder and let's call it Zebra. And then we're going to the Finder and there is the animation created in Adobe Illustrator using brushes and using an extension. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.